Okay, I stumbled across another video that I thought was really worth sharing, and I will be making a few comments as the video goes on, as you watch the video. And as usual, I am sharing this type of material because it is relevant. It is in the world around us. This is Babylon, Mystery Babylon, and Mystery Babylon should be exposed. We should know what is around us. We should know what is hidden in our faces and beneath our noses. Now, I understand that it's not for everybody. If it's not for you, then you know you don't have to watch the video. But I think it should be edifying for everybody to see the video. Of course, I don't agree with everything that will be said in this video because the speaker is sympathetic towards the Freemasons, and he is sympathetic toward whatever he believes Lucifer is. And so there is a few comments that he makes about Lucifer and about the Freemasons that are positive. You can, I don't have to tell you, I don't agree with what he says, okay? So, this is for those who would like to claim that I'm, probably sympathetic toward them as well. I'm not sympathetic toward the Freemasons, the Illuminati, or Lucifer, anything like that. I'm just exposing the stuff. Without further ado, we'll just get into the video.
Hundreds of years ago, Freemasons of the Scottish Rite 33rd Degree concealed in plain sight on the American landscape the Sigil of Lucifer. This conclusion is not speculative, born from a biased inclusion of supporting facts while excluding refuting facts. This symbol is there, deliberately placed. It cannot be a coincidence. And given the landmarks used in its formation, this map was designed before 1713, and the exact location of Washington, D.C. was already chosen. 60 years before the American Revolution, period. It cannot be any other way. And no, Freemasonry does not worship Satan, and their use of Lucifer as a symbol has nothing to do with the devil. Rather, it has everything to do with their quest for a land of liberty, free from the tyranny of the kings and the repressive church of Freemasonry's early days. The corners of the sigil are three places called Cedar Point. Cedar, an evergreen that survives the winter, is Freemasonry's symbol of immortality. These dates are the latest possible years that these landmarks could have been chosen for inclusion in this Masonic map. Based on the many alignments that make up the entire map, not all shown here, this map could only have been conceived in its entirety, planned all at once, at some time before 1713. This video is a glimpse of how I assembled this map. The viewer is likely to draw conclusions from this video alone if you haven't already drawn them. But such conclusions are premature, as it took an entire book to detail my analysis of the maps of supporting Masonic literature as written by high-ranking Freemasons for the education of their fellow Freemasons. The secrets of Masonry are not as complicated as many seem to make them. Freemasonry is an open book that, if interpreted symbolically, provides a clear narrative of its purpose and methods.
Let me just pause it here and state that he said that Freemasonry is an open book, and this is what I have discovered over the past year of studying this. They put their symbols right out in the open. They put it in books. They put it in movies and in music videos. They put it out there, and it's just up to you. It's up to you to read it or to observe it and to understand it. But it is pretty out in the open. So there isn't a whole lot that they do hide from us, but they do attempt to cover up the true identity of Lucifer without, at the same time, while putting it in our face.
In the Seal of Liberty, America's Quest for the Lost Treasure of Freemasonry, I reveal Masonry's original purpose and its secret clever methods for generating interest and offering its members the opportunity to discover its treasure. The map begins on Oak Island near Halifax, Nova Scotia. It has been the source of Masonic treasure speculation since at least 1795. On Oak Island, several large stones were observed in 1981 by Oak Island resident and longtime treasure hunter Fred Nolan to form a cross, often called a Nolan's Cross. In 2003, Rosicrucian researcher Petter Amundsen concluded that the number and placement of the stones better resembled a Kabbalah tree of life, which is a symbol used by Freemasonry. Amundsen's discovery of previously unknown stones in the places that he predicted seemed to validate his theory. I agree with Amundsen that the stones on Oak Island resemble a tree of life, and that his dimensions for that shape are correct. In the Seal of Liberty and in another video, I reveal a Masonic rendering of the Tree of Life which includes a Masonic compass and square. In Freemasonry, the compass symbolizes the spheres of the heavens. Its arms can be viewed symbolically as light radiating down from the heavens. Let's start drawing the map. The center column of Nolan's Cross and Amundsen's Tree of Life points directly at the Newport Tower in Newport, Rhode Island. Some researchers have speculated Freemasonry's involvement in the construction of the Newport Tower, but my work confirms it without question. The Newport Tower was built by Scottish Rite Freemasons in a specific location to symbolize Freemasonry's unfinished temple. By following the center column of the Tree of Life, we are starting our journey by following the balanced path. The primary path of Freemasonry can best be summarized as seek the light, so let's do that from now on. There are 2 days each year that have been symbolically significant throughout human history. They are the start of summer and the start of winter. These days are called the solstices. Over long periods of time, the locations of sunrise, symbolizing birth, and sunset, symbolizing death, on the solstices remain constant. In other words, they provide excellent markers that will remain constant for many generations. Without taking the time to explain why, our next move is to follow the bearing to the sun at sunset on the winter solstice at the Newport Tower. This path points to the lawn of the George Washington Masonic Memorial in Alexandria, Virginia, just outside Washington, D.C. Setting aside the sort of accuracy that we expect given our use of satellite imagery and computers, this line is a direct hit on the memorial itself from the Newport Tower, 350 miles away. Now let's seek the sunlight again. The bearing to sunset on the summer solstice at the George Washington Masonic Memorial creates a path from the George Washington Memorial to Sandusky, Ohio. Sandusky is the only town in the world whose city streets were modeled after the Masonic compass and square symbol. The sunset path on the summer solstice from the George Washington Masonic Memorial is a direct hit on the center of that compass and square. Cedar Point, which is due west of the Newport Tower, is the key to this location. The compass and square is a marker. Follow the winter solstice sunset at the Newport Tower to arrive at the George Washington Masonic Memorial in Alexandria. Follow the summer solstice sunset at the George Washington Masonic Memorial to arrive at Cedar Point in Ohio. Follow the sun at high noon at the George Washington Masonic Memorial to arrive at Cedar Point in North Carolina, which is due south of the memorial. Stand at the George Washington Masonic Memorial on the summer solstice, and the sun rises over the Newport Tower, birth, reaches high noon over Cedar Point, North Carolina, maturity, and sets over Cedar Point, Ohio, death. Cedar is Freemasonry's symbol of immortality. It is an evergreen that survives the winter. Now let's return to the map and its depiction of the Sigil of Lucifer. Cedar Point, Ohio bears 33 degrees west of north from Cedar Point, North Carolina. The Newport Tower bears 33.8 degrees east of north from Cedar Point, North Carolina. Why the 0.8 degree error from 33 degrees? Let's shift this line a little bit to the left, closer to 33 degrees. What do we find? What else but Cedar Point, Rhode Island? As we saw at the start, the center column of Amundsen's Oak Island Tree of Life points directly at the Newport Tower. If we continue this line, it also points at a north-pointed peninsula in Rhode Island called Cedar Point, as does our 33-degree line from Cedar Point, North Carolina. This gives us a triangle surrounding Washington, D.C. and the George Washington Masonic Memorial formed from three locations called Cedar Point. This is not a common name. To finish the left side of Lucifer's sigil, we must note the alignment of the left Cedar Point's line with the Statue of Liberty. Plot the bearings to sunrise and sunset on the solstices. The compass on our Tree of Life matches one of the solstice lines. finish the right side of our sigil, we note an alignment with the Tree of Life in Manhattan. The George Washington Masonic Memorial, the Statue of Liberty, and the Emmett Obelisk are all in a perfect line. This is not a coincidence. Manly Hall, a 33rd degree Scottish Rite Freemason and expert in Masonic and occult history, said of Lucifer, "Lucifer is the greatest mystery of symbolism. That Lucifer's true identity is a carefully guarded secret, and that Lucifer is represented by the number 741. 7 minus 4 equals 3, and 4 minus 1 equals 3, so 33 is hidden within 741. Where have we seen the numbers 741 before? Their reverse, 147, appears repeatedly on our map and throughout the Seal of Liberty. Of the six segments along the length of Amundsen's Oak Island Tree of Life, four of the segments are 147 feet long. The bearing from the Liberty Island flagpole to the center of Lady Liberty is 147 degrees. Liberty Island is 14.7 acres in size. Here's an example of another place that the number 147 shows up in the Seal of Liberty. The White House has 147 windows. That's an unusual and oddly coincidental number. The Latin word Lucifer means the light bringer, so a window is an apt metaphor. The original creators of Freemasonry used the Latin word Lucifer, meaning light bringer, as a symbol of enlightenment. To them, Lucifer does not represent the devil. So what on our map is Lucifer? What brings the light? The answer can be found in a statue created by French Freemasons and gifted to the Land of Liberty. Quote, "Liberty enlightening the world," end quote, is the real name of the Statue of Liberty.
And remember, scripture says that while they promise liberty, they themselves are slaves of corruption. And liberty, another word for liberty is, well, not another word, but the word liberty is related to the goddess Libertas, and they put the goddess on our money, on our coin, on top of the Capitol building, which is at the top of a pyramid that I've shown in videos past with the owl right behind her. They're out there in the grove worshiping her. Liberty, freedom. Freedom comes from Freya, the mother goddess, the Norse mother goddess. It all relates to her. As you know, as Manly P. Hall said, the identity of the true identity of Lucifer is a closely guarded secret. Yet at the same time, it's right there in our faces, like when they push the divas out there and they have Katy Perry dressed up as Isis, and they have Britney Spears with the serpent around her neck and sitting on the Star of Venus and all this other stuff. Lady Gaga coming out in a seashell or in a as a fallen angel in her video Guy, where she's this fallen angel laying down on the ground after being cast down. And you know, you don't think about what that means because you've already been told a certain narrative. So, but once again, as always, this is just my viewpoint. So if you don't agree, then that's fine. You take it to the Lord. You get it from Him. Let God be true and every man a liar.
The Statue of Liberty bears 147 degrees from the Liberty Island flagpole. It sits on 14.7 acres of land. In Freemasonry, reason liberates and liberty enlightens. Liberty brings the light. The identity of the Statue of Liberty is revealed by its Freemason architects through its geometry, through the numbers 147. The Statue of Liberty represents Lucifer, the Lightbringer, Freemasonry's symbol of liberty and enlightenment. The Latin word Lucifer was used by the Romans not as a name for the devil, but as a name for Venus, the bright queen of the heavens.
And so that's why they can let you see videos like this. That's why Freemasons can tell you their secrets in books, because they don't think you understand them in the first place. So they're not afraid to tell you what their secrets are. But if you know who they're talking about, then there's a problem for them. So let's go back and now listen to it again with the understanding that nature is Lucifer.
Wilding rose blows on the broken battlements of Tyre, and wolf rends the stones of Babylon. For beauty is eternal, and we bow to beauty everlasting. For lasting happiness, return to one alone. And she surrounds you now, great nature, refuge of the weary heart.